pour 2 gallons of water into your car, or maybe 2 quarts into your motorcycle? Well, of course you wouldn't. No engine can run on 10 or 20% water. But if you watch the YouTube videos where people test fuel additives, you might come away thinking that somehow ethanol is going to suck 20% water out of the atmosphere and leave it in your fuel. Well, that won't happen. Yet they test fuel additives by putting 10, 15, 20% water in a jar, adding some fuel additive, shaking it up, and voila, the water doesn't go anywhere. Well, of course not. Water is water, and this is a jar. Where's the water going to go? That's not how fuel additives work. Fuel additives work by picking up the small amounts of moisture that build up from condensation, or that 0.5% that will be absorbed by the ethanol in your fuel, and they help disperse it, remove it from your tank when you run your engine. You notice that part is never addressed in these videos, and that's because it's hard to do. So what we're going to do in this video is we're going to take a rig that I developed to take test tubes that hold exactly the same amount of fuel, exactly the same amount of water, and we're going to use 2%, because over a season you can get more condensation even after phase separation, and that will build up to 1 or 2% water in your tank. So we're going to put these test tubes in a rig that shakes them just like your vehicle does when you're driving it. A boat pounding down the water, a car run down the highway, it doesn't shake your water up like this, and it doesn't swirl in a high-speed mixer, but it does splash and slosh. And that's what we're going to do. And you'll see, under slow motion and high magnification, small water droplets moving up into the fuel column, further and more of them with the treated fuel. And that's how fuel additives can get rid of water and help reverse phase separation. We're going to start this test by taking some gasoline. We're going to put 50 milliliters into the cylinder. And we're going to divide it equally into these two test tubes. P for plain, S for the additive we're going to try, StarTron. See how close we got. Okay, that looks good. Now we're going to put in some green dyed water. One milliliter, half a milliliter. Half a milliliter. Half a milliliter.
2 drops. Of Star Tron.
That's the fuel additive we use to disperse the water. Now with a more vigorous shake, that'll pull all of the ethanol, or very close to all the ethanol, out. When we put it in the shaker, then we'll show what's really happening. This is the mixing rig that we're going to use for this test tube shaking test. It's run by a conventional drill, but it's got brackets that will lock the test tubes together. So whichever way they move, up, down, back, forth, side to side, they'll have the exact same energy on the fuel either direction. Both tubes will always show same amount of force. Unlike the many YouTube videos that put unrealistic amounts of water into gasoline in a jar in order to do a fuel additive test, in this video, the goal was to show you what really happens in your vehicle and how to not only prevent phase separation, but if it has occurred, to recover from phase separation using a fuel additive that disperses water during the actual application. Now, in this video, we used 2% water, and that can actually occur in your boat or your motorcycle when it's been sitting for an entire season, particularly with a vented fuel tank, and if you've left the fuel really low, a quarter tank or less, so you can have enough airspace to entrain that much moisture. Now, in this test, we used the amount of water that can actually be absorbed over a season. We treated it with the correct amount of fuel additive, not overdosing it, and we applied a shaking technique that is designed to mimic the real-world vibration and sloshing of a fuel tank. And in this video, under slow motion you can clearly see very small water droplets are being formed, and a lot more of them with the fuel additive that we use for this test, Tron Enzyme Fuel Treatment. Now this fuel additive disperses the water in tiny drops that move further up into the fuel column. So when that vehicle is running, more water and more of the ethanol that's tied to the water will be burned off. Over a period of time, this method safely removes even phase-separated water. Now, it won't fix every situation if it's been left for years and years and you have more water than either a standpipe in an old vehicle or that will be picked up in the intake tube of the fuel pump. It's going to bring too much water into your fuel and you can't start the engine. But in most situations, the fuel, even at a season of sitting, will still start the engine. And with StarTron, you'll pick up small amounts of water and small amounts of ethanol at the same time and burn them off slowly. And this is how dispersant fuel additives work. It's not magic, but it is science. And it's very clear the product does what the manufacturer says it will do. So unless you're planning to pour 2 gallons of water into your vehicle, rest assured that you won't get that kind of contamination in the real world, and that a water dispersing additive like StarTron will solve any problems that you have. Now, thanks for watching my video, and please subscribe.